Hello students, it's day 3 for chapter measurement. The specific objectives of today's topic are measurement of density and relation of SI and CGS unit of density. So open page number 12 of your physics textbooks. Students, in previous lectures of measurement, we have discussed measurement of area and measurement of volume. Today we are going to discuss measurement of density. What is density? Density of a substance is defined as mass per unit volume of a substance. Density is equals to mass upon volume, where mass is quantity of matter contained in an object. That how much of matter is there in an object, that defines its mass. And volume, we have done it in previous lecture, that amount of space occupied by an object is called its volume. Density, so it is mass upon volume. It is a characteristic property of a substance. That means that each substance has its own density at room temperature. And SI unit of density is kg per meter cube. From mass it comes to kg and volume it is meter cube. So SI unit of density becomes kg per meter cube. Now next is how density is related to mass and volume. If mass of an object increases, the density of an object also increases. If mass will increase, density will also increase for same volume. That means volume should be constant in that situation. Mass increases, density will also increase. Mass decreases, density will also decrease. Next is, if volume of an object increases, the density of an object will decrease. That means, if volume here increases, density will decrease for same mass. Mass should be constant here. Mass constant, volume increases, density decreases. Or if volume decreases, density will increase. Now, next is how density changes with the expansion or contraction of a substance. On expansion, the volume of an object increases as the space occupied by an object also increases. On contraction, the volume of an object decreases as the space occupied by an object also decreases. Hence, if volume will change, the density will also change. We have done it earlier. Now, as objects expand on heating and contract on cooling, so density also changes on expansion or contraction. For in the case we are taking an object when heated, it expands. It expands means its dimensions increase. Hence, the space occupied by an object also increases, thus its volume increases. If its volume will increase, its density will decrease. Next topic is relation between SI and CGS unit of density. SI unit of density is kg per meter cube. And CGS unit is gram per centimeter cube. Now we are going to find its relation. 1 kg by meter cube is equals to 1 kg upon 1 meter multiplied by 1 meter multiplied by 1 meter. 1 kg is equals to 1000 grams. 1 meter equals to 100 centimeter. 1 meter 100 centimeter. 1 meter 100 centimeter. Cutting off the zeros, we'll get 1 upon 1000 gram per centimeter cube. The relation here comes up as 1 kg per meter cube is equals to 1 upon 1000 gram per centimeter cube. Or you can write it as 1000 kilogram per meter cube is equals to 1 gram per centimeter cube. Now we'll start up with the reading of density on page number 12. Measurement of density of regular solids. Density we have discussed as is defined as the ratio of mass of a body to its volume. That is, mass upon volume is called density. Density is represented by D. The symbol for density is capital D. The density of a pure substance varies little from sample to sample and is often considered a characteristic property of a substance. If we take pure substance as iron, then density of iron varies little from sample to sample depending upon what piece of iron we have taken and is often considered as a characteristic property of a substance, means that the density of iron is a constant value. That is, it does not change from place to place. Its value remains constant. So it is a characteristic property of a substance. Most substances undergo expansion when heated and therefore have lower density at higher temperature. Underline, lower density at higher temperature. As we have discussed that at high temperature, the body expands. On expansion, the volume increases and hence the density decreases. So they have lower density at high temperatures. Many substances, especially gases, can be compressed into a smaller volume by increasing the pressure acting on them. As on compressing, the volume will decrease, and if its volume will decrease, its density will also be changed. For these reasons, the temperature and pressure at which the density of a substance is measured are usually specified, so that the density of a substance remains constant. The density of a gas is often converted mathematically to what it would be at standard temperature and pressure. The temperature and pressure should be standard, should be fixed for measuring the density of any gas. Water is unusual in that it expands and thus decreases in density as it is cooled below 3.98 degrees Celsius. That is its temperature of maximum density. Students, this is anomalous behavior of water. Ano means different and malus means behavior. That is behavior different from normal. This anomalous behavior of water says that when water is cooled below 4 degrees Celsius, rather than contraction, it expands. And thus, on expansion, its volume increases and hence its density starts decreasing. So, at 4 degrees Celsius, the density of water is maximum. It has a density of 1 gram per centimeter cube or 1000 kilogram per meter cube at 3.98 degrees Celsius, and this is the maximum density of water. Density is often taken as an indication of how heavy a substance is. Iron is denser than cork since a given volume of iron is more massive than the same volume of cork. Yes, iron is more denser. We have discussed the case that when volume is constant for two objects and mass varies. Here, mass of iron will be obviously more than that of cork for the same volume. Same volume means the space occupied by both of them is same. So, iron will have more mass. It will be more heavier than that of cork. Cork is a rubber piece. So, its density will be more than that of cork. It is often said that iron is heavier than cork. Although a large volume of cork obviously can be more massive and thus be heavier than a small volume of iron. So, we cannot compare density with the weight. Density and weight are two different concepts. As small volume of iron will weigh less than a large volume of cork or rubber piece. Now, units of density. The SI unit of density we have done, density is mass upon volume, mass kilogram, and volume meter cube. So SI unit of density is kg per meter cube. In CGS unit, it is measured as gram per cubic centimeter. We have done the relation also that 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Here it should be 1 gram centimeter raised to power minus 3. It is written here centimeter raised to power minus 1. Just correct it. It is 1 gram per centimeter cube is equals to 1000 kilogram per meter cube.
Now, learning outcomes of today's topic are, first is
measurement of density and its SI unit. Second is relation between density and mass for constant volume. Yes, it is directly proportional. If mass of an object increases, density will also increase. If mass of an object decreases, the density will also decrease. So they are directly proportional to each other. Next is relation between density and volume for constant mass. It is inversely proportional. If volume of an object will increase, then density will decrease. Or if volume will decrease, the density will increase. The last one is relation between SI and CGS unit of density.